Hello and welcome by another video of the Arcad Saga. Actually, I could say another care collab, and I'm really happy to join in on this one as well. We're going to talk about a beautiful Arcad, if you ask me, and it's this one. It's the BLC Amethyst, and as you can see, mine is not that big, yet it's quite a fairly young plant, but I think it's enjoying is place here in my greenhouse. It is has one new growth there and an even bigger new growth there, so that looks kind of promising, I think. And I bought this one, I actually repotted on March 14th from this year. And most of the times I repot my new orchids within a week if I can. And even though they do not have new growing tips, most of the times I'm potting them up, just water them as I would do in when they came in bark, in this case. And then I slowly build that watering up. And thereby I mean, as soon as I see new growing tips like this one, I fill up the reservoir. I have a water meter here and I can tap that, and if it goes back, I know there's still water in the reservoir. But then they are settling in self-watering. So I don't fill up the reservoir straight away, but I, like I said, I wait a little bit until I see growth activity in the pot. And before we go into this care collab any further, let me talk about a little bit and briefly about the other ones who are participating with today's care collab. And that is, the first one is Tots Tropicals. Then we have Ray Race Garden. And then we have Ninja Arcids, Nina from Ninja Arcids. I hope that you will check out those videos as well. And I forget to mention that quite often, I apologize for that, but if you want to join in on one of these care collabs, please leave a comment at one of the videos and we will reach out to you guys. Okay, let's move on and take a look about this orchid. And we are now in my orchid room, where I have most of my cooler growers, like the Miltoniopsises, and where I also do my repots. And I now have this amethyst, BLC amethyst, on the table, and we will have a look at the root system. So I'm going to take the orchid out of its pot, out of the outer pot, and I will turn out the screen now for the camera. I'm sorry if it wiggles a bit, but I can now see what I'm doing. And here we go. Let's have a look first at the, like I said, at the roots inside of this pot. And you probably can see there's some water dripping. This one is fully established, or basically established in this system. It's a fairly new planted one in this system, so it's not fully adapted, but it really starts working its way around the system. And I think it's agreeing to it, because we see here, I hope you can see it. Let me try to zoom in a little bit. Other way, yes, there we go. And you can see we have beautiful roots here. And also we have here a new root that is finding its way. We have one here. So that's beautiful. Let's turn it around. This is the back side of the orchid, but that's the front, I'm sorry. And we have also some roots here. Let me lower this down. Beautiful green roots that are fully adapted to this new system. And we have even one here. You can see on the bottom the reservoir level, if it's filled, is around here, I think. So this one is completely adapted to being in water. And that's beautiful, of course. That means that this orchid is liking the system so far. But what I always do, and what I will do now again, is I check the reservoir. I keep an eye on what's happening in here. It's kind of looks a little bit dusty. I don't know if it shows on camera, but that is actually some seaweed, and I have this powder stuff. I will grab it very quickly. It's called TNC Micor Hydro. Let me show it in the screen. And I will talk about this stuff a bit more in the future. If I have the time, I will take some time for it and explain why I use this. But it has quite some different types of bacteria that should be good for the plants. So once every, I think, 3 months, about something about that, I will give a little bit of this stuff in the water, and then it turns quite brown, and that is the, it stays a little bit dusty, and sometimes I have actually some seaweed things growing. It's yeah, I don't have it, this one doesn't have it on a pot, I think. No, it's some, I think it's seaweed growing, but it doesn't receive any light, so it doesn't really grow much and turns out to getting too big. So it's not a problem, but that's the stuff you see floating around. And that's okay, because I think the plants can, it's been very beneficial for the plants. And I use this because I use inorganic media with my plants. So therefore I try to get some organic media in there that they would have when they would be fully grown in bark, and other organic stuff. But because I did take the organic as out as much as I could, I try to copy with that and yeah, to give the plants something they basically need and to grow and to be happy. I also, before I forget it, you see some bark left over there. That was because there were some roots attached to that bark, and sometimes I'm just leaving it in if it's only a little bit. I don't want to damage all the roots then. But I decided while I am repotting if I let it stay there or not. If I let it stay there, I know this orchid didn't have much roots to begin with. So I therefore try to help it a little bit by leaving it there. Meanwhile, I grab my pH meter and I will put it in the reservoir. I hope you can see that. We will measure the pH and pores per million. That goes a little bit quicker. That meter works a little bit quicker. Okay. This one is around 210. My limit is 200 or more. So this is obviously more. So I'm going to flush this one. I regularly flush, but this one needs a cleanup. The reservoir is too full with parts per million. That happens with kind of young plants who are not that long in the system. Then I basically always at least have to flush once after, let's say, 3 months, something like that. So that I'm used to that. I was expecting this because, like I said, this plant isn't big enough to really use all the fertilizer that I give it. And also, it doesn't have the roots for it yet. Probably when I now flush it in 2 or 3 months, I do not have to flush it again, because I do not give them too much fertilizer. In summer, it's around 100 to 130, something like that. And you can see the pH is 7.22 if you want to be exact. That's a little bit high. This was to be expected. Because the materials I use, basically most of this is pumice and a little bit of leca downside there, underneath in that pot. I can show it quickly to you. That brown stuff there is the leca. That does raise the pH in the beginning, so this was also to be expected. On the other hand, I test this every year. This is what I now do every 3 months for every orchid that I have. And if it's too low, let's say it was a 5.0 or something like that, I will put a little bit of calcium in there. And it's a powder form that is used for inorganic materials to keep the medium longer, so you can use it longer. That's how they sell it, but it also works to keep the pH inside of that reservoir higher, or to bring it up again. So I could have brought this up around 7 or even a little bit more, because I try to copy, I try to mimic what happens in the beginning when you start growing your orchids in self-watering. So that pH is a little bit on the high side, but when I water, I have water around, let's say, 5.5 pH-wise to maximum 6.5. So I try to mimic the system of self-watering, semi-hydroponic. If you are familiar with it, you know exactly what I'm talking about. I adjust the pH because this is on the high end. I hope that makes sense. If you have any questions, don't be afraid. Just ask them, because I try to explain this as well as I can. But I can imagine you have some questions about the system. If you don't forget, I will put some links in where I do explain it even more than I do now. But I think it's very important to talk about it, because it's a care guide. It's a care collaboration. And this is a big part, probably the most important part of how I give care to also this orchid. So therefore I put this in, and like I said, if you have any questions, you know what to do. Leave me a comment and I will find it. Okay, but what I said is that it's a little too high ppm wise, so I'm going to flush it. Let's get over to the sink. It's really behind me, but I need to have a little different camera angle so you can see what I'm doing. So I will set up the camera and we will start flushing this orchid. So what we're first going to do is clean out this outer pot, because I do that when the PPMs are quite high, because there's always some residue there. So I'm gonna add some media. That's okay, it always falls a little bit through the holes underneath in the orchid pots. It's not even that dirty, I'm sorry, I hope you can see it. It's a little bit residue, like I said. That's basically it. Sometimes I have, almost looks like algae on the sides of the pots. I'm not really sure it is algae, I don't think so, because I have black pots. But there's a lot of dirt that gets stuck to the side of the pot. I have to wash it out, but I don't think I have to do it with this one. I just run some tap water through it. And yeah, that should be okay. It's a fairly new orchid, and most of the times it stays clean enough for a few months. So yeah, this is a beautiful new pot. I have already here my orchid, of course. I will place it on this rack so I can really nicely flush it through. I did grab some RO water and I put in some Algamic from Biobis. It's a really good brand if you ask me. I really like them. And Algamic, algae, kelp is good to have for the roots and to get the orchid started. It's a natural hormone, so I use it just a little bit in the water, and I really like that to get the orchid happy and going again. And I like to use this a little cup to flush through. It's a little bit easier to handle than the big one. So I'm just going to flush through, run the water through, and okay. That's basically it. This is all I have. Now, flush it through with beautiful clean water, and I will put it back in a pot. And then I'm going to fill up the reservoir again. I hope you can see the water meter. Yes, I think you can see it. This is the water meter. If everything goes well, this one did get a little bit stuck. This will go up in a second when I fill the reservoir. And that's my method when I water on my orchids. I keep an eye on this thing. It's very easy to water my orchids this way. It should go up. Yes, there it goes. I hope you can see it. Yeah. And it's so easy if you have 300 plus orchids. If you can water them like this, and those meters give you the indication if they have enough water in that reservoir. Seriously, guys, I couldn't live without them. But yeah, this is what I do when I have too much parts per million in the water or too high pH. And now we're done, I can bring it back in the greenhouse. So let's do that, and we will talk a little bit further about this orchid over there. And there she is, back at the corner of that shelf, and she is joined around some family members, Brassifolia types, crushes, BLCs. I have a few of them. I have them over there. I like to group them together, and next to them are my Cattleyas. But I will zoom out. I'm sorry if that goes a little bit quick, but I have them on this shelf, and they receive quite some beautiful daylight. I think it's not too strong, because the leaves of this orchid, the amethyst, are nice and green. I think they have a nice color. And so therefore I keep an eye on that. If they would get purple, like the neighbor, I probably would adjust it. This one is recently came from another place where it did get a little bit more light, so that's said and done. This is this video is about this one, the amethyst, but I did flush this, and thereby I watered a little bit, threw a little bit of water over this new growth. If it was colder in here, I definitely would keep an eye on that, because it's quite high temperature wise. Let me grab my temperature meter quickly. We're going to over show it to you guys so you can see what I'm talking about. We have 23 degrees Celsius with a humidity level of 75. So that's kind of high. I like it around 60, 65, but I just watered my vendas, and those are basically next to the meter, so thereby it's not that high, but it's a little bit higher measurement. But this new growth should be okay. It will dry off quite quickly with these temperatures. But that's basically it what I can talk about. It's like I said, I'm fairly new to this one, so therefore this is how I take care for it. And one day, absolutely, of course, I hope to see some blooms, because it's a really beautiful plant. And if I'm correct, someone who is collaborating with us in this care collab has this one in bloom. So I definitely would check out the other channels. And one day, like I said, I hope that I can film this in bloom as well. Once again, as usual, if you have any questions, please leave them in the comment sections. And if you have any suggestions, of course, they are welcome as well. For now, like I said, yeah, I just want to say thank you. And I have quite a new number of subscribers. All of you guys who were already here, and the new ones, thank you so much. I hope you feel welcome here, and I hope you enjoy my videos. I really try my best. I notice that sometimes I just forget things. I really need to work on that. I try my best, but if you see something or you think I leave something out very important, please leave a comment in the comment section. That would be highly appreciated. And for now, I just hope to see you at one of my next videos. Bye bye.